The McLaren F1 is a car that many consider to be the greatest ever made. The McLaren F1 is a masterpiece in car engineering that not only boasts of a sleek design, but also an adaptability you don't typically get with cars like this. Today, we're going to take a look at all the features and specifications that stand this car apart from its competition, from the innovative interior design and custom-made seats to the unmatched top speed. We'll explore what it is about the McLaren F1 that makes you want to never use another car again. McLaren didn't just build any standard sports car. The McLaren F1 is a three-seat, light and aerodynamic supercar built for the road. Despite that, the F1 has seen victories on the track, winning out against purpose-built race cars at the 1995 24 Hours of Le Mans. And in March 1998, the XP5 prototype went on to set the Guinness World Record for the fastest production car at 240 miles per hour.
391.
Smashing the previous world record set in 1993 by the Jaguar XJ220 at 217 miles per hour. That mad speed comes from a custom-made 620 horsepower BMW V12 engine. For many years before the McLaren F1 was built in the late 1980s, the sports car industry was in a phase where they constantly try to outdo each other, usually either by adding some new technological perk or coming up with a fresh design to make the cars look sleeker or upping engine power so they go faster. McLaren, however, would take their time building the F1, having been working on it since the 60s, and that patience and care would pay off massively. Let's get into some of those features that make the McLaren special. First off, the seats. The McLaren F1 are famous for their three-seat setup. On the inside of the car, you have two laid-back passenger seats, one on the left and one on the right. But there's also an unconventional center seat, which you typically don't get in sports cars, or any car for that matter. The center seat leans a little more forward than the two flanking seats. This middle seat serves as the car's driver's seat. The seat's length and distance from the pedals are configured to the driver from the factory, making sure the setup is perfect for the car owner. The center seat has two belts coming from above the driver's seat headrest to ensure the driver's strapped in. McLaren took advantage of the center seat setup to put some controls on either side of the driver, which means some buttons to the right of the driver and some to the left, perfectly balanced. For example, you've got the parking brake on the driver's left side and the gear switch on the right. Another interesting thing about the center seat is that due to the air intake vent on the roof that leads air to the back of the car where the engine is, the F1 has two back windows, one on either side of the vent mechanism. So, consequently, the driver gets two rear view mirrors on either side of him to see through the back windows. This center seat design is brilliant. Not only does it allow for the F1 to have two passenger seats, which is one more than most other sports cars, making it ever so slightly more family friendly, but it also provides the driver the rare comfort of driving from the middle of the car, which is ideally how all cars should operate. The forward-leaning seat lets the driver judge the road better and gives him a better view for turns and reversal. Moving on from there, if you look closer on the door jams, there's a latch labeled L that opens up the luggage section. Yeah, you heard that right. This sports car has a luggage section, and it's not as small as you'd imagine and is on both sides of the car. Again, giving this luxury car a more efficient use, emphasizing that you really can just use this car as your only car and go on road trips with it, instead of just being an exhibition piece you stash away in a garage somewhere. But next to the luggage section, there's a plaque listing off some of McLaren's iconic racing victories, just reminding the car owner that this car can go super fast. Now, we can't talk about the McLaren F1 without mentioning its prestigious engine. Next to the L luggage latch on the door jams is another latch labeled E. Once that is pulled, the hood pops up at the back of the car to reveal the revered BMW V12 engine. As we mentioned earlier, it's 620 horsepower, and it's very special. It wasn't put in any other road car, and that's because it's essentially a racing engine. This was the engine the modified F1 GTR used when it beat out actual racing cars to win the Le Mans in 95. Outside of the engine itself, the engine compartment is another innovative and impressive feat of craftsmanship. Well, we said earlier there's two back mirrors on the car, Well, turns out there's four. Two behind the passenger seats on either side of the driver's seat, and another two on the engine hood itself, since it runs over the inner two. When the hood is open, you see the vents that run all the way from the roof of the car into the engine compartment to channel air into the engine, which is a genius way to keep the engine cool. But now, due to the sheer power of the V12 engine, the exhaust area located just behind the engine closer to the tail of the car can get seriously hot, and the McLaren team is worried that this overheating could damage the carbon fiber the car is made out of. So they came up with the idea of lining the entire exhaust compartment with pure gold. Actual pure gold. Yep, the gold lining would absorb and reflect the heat produced by the exhaust. So here's a neat fact. Every last one of all 106 McLaren F1s in existence contains 0.8 ounces of pure gold under the hood. How posh is that? Speaking of carbon fiber, the entire body of the F1 is made from a carbon fiber reinforced polymer, one of the earliest cars to ever do that. The major perk of this polymer use, and the reason the car needed to be shielded from the exhaust with gold, is the sheer lightness of the material. The McLaren F1 was built with weight in mind. The car is about as light as possible to increase the aerodynamics of the car for better handling and greater speed. In order to achieve this, though, they went beyond just using a carbon-based polymer. They saved weight wherever possible. First off, the CD changer in the front compartment of the car is a specially made Kenwood brand with aluminum magnets inside of it. The magnets work to make it considerably lighter than all other CD changers in road cars, and this alone, just simply cutting weight on a regular CD changer, saved about 6 ounces. Then, also in that front compartment of the car is a small toolkit where every tool in it, such as your regular old spanner or Allen keys, are made of titanium instead of iron or steel, making it about 50% lighter than a regular toolkit. Even though that only saves a few ounces, it counts. Moving on inside the car, we return to the seats. Because the unconventional extra seat doesn't add as much weight as you think, they're relatively simple and stripped back seats without much or any adjustment controls. That's because when you buy the car, McLaren measures you and custom installs the seats to your specific size and preferences in terms of distance from the wheel, how straight you want to sit, and where you want the pedals to be. The reason for this is that it allows the car to come with a lighter seat rather than a power seat with tons of control or a railing at the bottom of it to adjust distance. This, coupled with the other things we just went through, work together to make the McLaren F1 one of the lightest road cars out there. So all in all, when you take into consideration the unconventional yet comfortable three-seat setup, the navigational advantage of a central driving seat, a luggage or trunk section, whilst also being a super light high-speed sports car, as well as the innovative and never-seen-before engine design, not to mention pure gold as a heat insulator, what you have is a supercar that's not only technologically advanced, luxurious, and offers a super unique driving experience, but a sports car that actually feels practical to use out on the road. It's no wonder this thing costs north of $20 million. Truly, the McLaren F1 was decades ahead of its time, and we may never see another supercar like it.